Let us see how to create a new company. In order to create a new company, the user has to go to Settings, General, and click on the Company option. The Company Overview screen will be displayed. In the Company Overview screen, we can view the existing companies which are created, and we can also create a new company by clicking on the New button. In order to make any kind of changes in an existing company, we just need to double click on that company's record. This will allow us to edit the details of that company. Now, to add a new company, we need to click on the New button. Here, first we need to enter the short name of the company. This is the name which would be used to represent this company throughout the application. Next, we need to create a username and a password which they can use to log into their portal. Username must be a valid email address, as it will be useful to access the account as well as to recover the password in case the user will forget the same. Rest of the informations are non-mandatory, like the mobile numbers and the address of the company. The another information which we can enter over here is the Disable All Object option. With this option, all the objects or the vehicles of the company can be disabled temporarily. Once this option is selected, the vehicles in the company will start reporting to the server until the option is deselected. And finally, the company can upload their logo by using the upload option. The next tab is the company rule tab. Company rule allows a company to define their own rule according to their requirement. Let us understand each and every property of the company rule in detail. Rule name. Rule name can be defined for identifying the rules created for each company. Valid from date. Each rule has a valid from date, which helps the system to understand from when the rule will be applicable. Device accuracy tolerance. Each GPS device has a different accuracy. Trakzee has an option where the user can define device accuracy tolerance. By default, the value is considered as 20 meters. For example, if an object is parked at one location and it sends data every 10 seconds. In each data, if there is a variation in the location packet of about 20 to 30 meters, then it shows inappropriate data on the map. To avoid this, we can define device accuracy tolerance according to the accuracy of the device. Device distance variation. Few GPS hardware have a problem that they do not show the accurate distance traveled. For such scenarios, Trakzee has an option where the user can add or remove incorrect distance to get the accurate distance on each report. For example, in a company, each device has a problem in calculating the correct distance. If the object covers a distance of 100 km, then the device sends only 90 km. This scenario shows a 10% variation in the distance, which can be corrected using the device distance variation option. POI tolerance. POI is point of interest. POI tolerance is an area around the POI, or it is the radius of that POI. Speed tolerance. When the GPS device is not attached to the ignition port, it is difficult to identify whether the vehicle is in running mode or stop mode. So, speed tolerance can be set to identify the running status of the vehicle. SMS alert from and SMS alert to. This facility gives convenience to receive SMS on a specified time period. For example, if the user wants to have SMS alerts only during the daytime, then he can define this time frame. So, the SMS alert will be sent on the company only for the specified time frame. Inactive duration. Sometimes the device is unable to send location data due to unavailability of GPS or GPRS. Company always want to see these kind of devices as inactive devices. Trakzee has an option where the user can define device's inactive time duration. In that scenario, if the device is not sending data beyond the defined time duration, then that object status will be shown as inactive. Stoppage duration. When the GPS device is not attached to the ignition port, then it is difficult to identify whether your vehicle is in stop mode or not. Trakzee has an option where the company can set stoppage duration to identify the stop status of the vehicle. For example, if the company has set 5 minutes stoppage duration, now there is one vehicle which is not connected to the ignition port. When that particular vehicle speed is 0 for more than 5 minutes, then that vehicle will be considered as stopped. Idle duration. Company has an option to define idle duration for their objects. If the object is stopped at one location while the ignition is on for more than a defined period, then that object will be considered in idle mode. For example, if the company has set the idle duration for 3 minutes, if one of the object is stopped with the ignition on for more than 3 minutes, then that object will be considered in idle mode. Startup screen. Company can define their own startup screen from this option. This startup screen will be visible to each user after login under that company. Welcome message. If the company wants to show a welcome message instead of showing a startup screen, then this option can be used. With this option, the company can set any custom message for the users. Now, once clicked on the save button, the company rule will be saved and applied. The next tab is the user settings tab. Here you can define various preferences for the user. User setting mostly contains configuration setting which can enable or disable various functionality of the software. The first setting is for time zone. Here we need to select the time zone of the locality of the user from where the account is going to be operated. Date and time format. Here we can define the format in which the date and time should be displayed throughout the portal. Unit of distance. User can select the unit of distance to be kilometers, miles, or nautical miles, which will be considered as per selection for that specific user. User status. Here we can define whether to keep this user active or inactive. Stored user action. By keeping this on, the parent level user can review all activities done by this specific user. Activities can be accessing any screen, opening, deleting, or editing operations, etc. Activities can be checked in the user access report in the logs section of the report module. One more use of this option is that the user can set his preferences like theme setting, language preferences, etc. and it does not have to be set again every time the user logs in. Show default filter option. By keeping this feature as on, it will enable the feature to select or deselect columns on each report and it will reflect accordingly on all user sessions. Smooth live tracking. With this function, the vehicles will be shown in a continuous moving state instead of showing frequent jumps in the live tracking. Immobilization. By selecting this option, the user will be able to use the immobilize feature if the port is attached on an object in the web and mobile app. Mobile app notification. It is mandatory to select it in order for the user to receive the mobile app notifications for alerts in their mobile application. Web access. By selecting this option, the user will be able to access the platform through the web application. Mobile access. By selecting this option, the user will be able to access the platform through the mobile application. It can restrict the user access from other mobiles by configuring specific IMEI numbers in comma separated values. The next step is screen access. Screen access will allow the parent level user to provide the rights of no access, view, modify, or add or delete. If the rights are given as no access, then the user will not get access to that particular screen. If the rights are given as view, then the user will be able to view the contents of the screen but won't be able to make any kind of modifications. Modify. If the rights are set as modify, then the user will be able to modify the records on the screen. And finally, if the rights are set as add or delete, then the user will be able to add and delete the contents as well. In case if any existing user is having the same rights which needs to be assigned to the newly creating user, then that can be done by selecting the user from the drop-down list of copy from user group. Data access. Data access allows the parent to give specific access of alerts for the newly created user. So the user will get the rights according to this configuration. Default language. Here, the user can set the default language for the newly created account. So the respective user will get all the details in this default language only. It can also be changed by the user after logging into their own account also. Map. It allows the user to use their own map purchased from any service provider listed within the platform. First of all, the user has to select the map service provider from the drop-down list. In the key field, the user has to insert the map key provided from the map service provider. The user must have received these details from the service provider. The system will use map details as per the configuration for the respective user, and the same will get reflected on the platform for any users created within that account. Email. From the email option, the user can configure their own email account by filling all the fields asked during configuration. Email account can be a bulk email service having the functionality to send multiple emails at the same time. Email configuration will be used by the system in various features where the system is configured to send details over email, for example alerts, scheduled report, share location, etc. The from email address. Email address from which the details are going to get shared should be mentioned over here. It will appear as the sender of that email in the recipient's account. Other parameters will be received from the service provider while purchasing the subscription, like username, password, host, and outgoing port. By clicking on the test configuration button, we can test if the configuration created are correct or not. If the configurations are correct, a confirmation email will be received on the email address which is used to test the configuration. SMS. From the SMS option, the user can configure their own SMS API by filling the fields which are required. SMS configuration will be used by the system in various features where the system is configured to send details over SMS, for example, alerts, share location, etc. SMS gateway. The user must have to select the SMS gateway option as inherit or custom. Inherit. This option can be used if the parent level user has configured their own SMS service and the newly creating user wants to use the same service. It can be selected as custom if the newly creating user wants to configure their own SMS service and don't want to use their parent level user's SMS service. SMS gateway URL. It needs to get filled only if the SMS gateway has been selected as custom. If the user has purchased bulk SMS service and wants to integrate the same, they must have received the bulk SMS API from the service provider. The same needs to get configured here. Variables. It indicates that the user must have to replace the given variables as #2 in place of recipient's number and #message in place of the message to be sent to the recipient through API. The SMS gateway URL can be configured only after replacing the variables as described. The system will not be able to send any detail over SMS in case of any deviation in the variable replacement. The Add New Template option. It allows the user to add their own customized template for SMS alert. It can be configured for each alert type and the same needs to get approved from the SMS service provider. The recipient will not receive any message in case of any deviation between the approved templates and the templates added from this option. The next tab is Branch. If a company has its branches at various different locations, then those branches can be added by clicking on the Add New button. The details like the branch name and other information like the mobile numbers and address related information can be entered here. And when clicked on the Save button, the branch will be added under the company. The last tab is Rename Label. Rename Label is simply changing the name of the label from one to the other. For example, if we click on Add New, and if the label name of object needs to be changed to Vehicle, then the actual name we can enter as Object, and in the new name we can enter Vehicle. So in the platform, the word Object will be replaced by Vehicle. Now, once we click on the Save button, the company will be created. Now let us check the concept of sub-accounts. Sub-accounts are normal accounts which have different screen access than each other and can be controlled by one specific company with a single branch or multiple branches. Sub-account can be created only from existing companies by double-clicking on the company's record and going to the Sub-accounts tab. Here, the user can click on the Add New button and the details to be entered are My Account. Here, a username and a password needs to be created with which the normal user can log in. The username must be a valid email address as it will be used to access the account as well as to recover password in case the user will forget the same. Data access. Here, we need to select the company, branch and objects which should be visible to the normal user. We can also select the language of the user. Screen access. Here also, the screen access can be selected. This option is similar to the one seen before while creating the company. User setting. User setting mostly contains the configuration setting which can enable or disable various functionality of the software. This option is also similar to the one seen before while creating the company. When clicked on the Save button, the sub account or the normal user will be added under the company.